Do you know Space Invaders? Well, give it a little math and boom, there you have it. Grace Counter. You control either this ship or this ship in order to shoot them up while avoiding the enemy's bullets. So what makes this any different from the other games with spaceships and anime girls? Well, first of all, at least one of these is an actual girl, so watch out for that. Secondly, these 2 meters. You can avoid the projectiles completely or live dangerously by grazing them to fill up this meter that gives you a laser attack and invisibility while you fire it. From there you get yellow stars that fill up this other meter to fire rather powerfully but without any invincibility, so make sure to still keep track on all the other projectiles. In a way, Grace Counter reminds me a lot of Nuclear Throne, a game that serves you and controls shootouts but actually beats you over the head with a newspaper if you get too cute for your own good. They want you to be wild and quick on your feet, yes, but at the same time, pure recklessness won't get you all that far. It's the same here, you have to get accustomed to the layout of the stages, when to shoot, when to dodge, when to charge up the meters, which parts of the screen are safer and on what moments, and especially when to use the grace and break counters. And then comes the fun part, actually pulling all of that off. What I highlight the most is how the 3 main qualities of this game can be exemplified with an actual stage. In stage 2, the fundamental mechanics are in perfect sight, even more so I'd say than in stage 1, since in the format the game starts forcing you to put more thought behind using the counters. Stage 3 will blow you away on the first playthrough, no doubt. Even though it's way shorter, keeping an eye on all that stuff at the same time might seem impossible, especially during the boss fight. And stage 5, oh god, stage 5 is beautiful. I wish every stage had something as astonishing as the part when your ship goes over the sea and back to the sky. This is the kind of game that really catches me. This isn't a 60-hour game where the horse's balls are in 4K with an epic narrative and unnecessary rope physics. This is a game in which you play the same stages for as long as you feel like getting better, with a couple of modes and characters. It manages to get the most out of what it is, despite it not being the big fancy type of game. The game is on PlayStation, on Xbox, on Switch even. Of course, you can find it on Steam, so you can have it on PC for around $30. However it may be, just go play Grace Counter. It's really good, man. I promise.